Welcome to Audio Video System playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dulakia, is going to explain you horn loudspeaker in this session. So basically horn type loudspeaker that we will be going to study in complete detail in this session. And to understand horn type loudspeaker, these are my session outlines, where first I'm going to explain basics of horn type loudspeaker. After that, we will be going to see structure of horn type loudspeaker. Then we will see working of horn type loudspeaker. Then after, I'll explain you different characteristics which is there with horn type loudspeaker. And then we will see advantages and disadvantages. And at the end, we'll sum up this session with applications of horn type loudspeaker. So these are the points which I will be covering in this session. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of horn type loud. Now see, instead of radiating acoustic power directly in open space to the listener area, power is first delivered to the air in trap fixed vibrating tapered flare horn, and then it will go to the air. So basically, if you observe this horn type loudspeaker, then in that, as we have seen it for the case of cone type loudspeaker, there was cone which was vibrating along with diaphragm. But in case of horn type loudspeaker, there is loudspeaker which is generating sound, and that sound that we are redirecting by having horn, where horn is not actually generating audio signal, horn is just directing audio signal. While in case of cone type loudspeaker, you can see it is vibrating along with diaphragm and it generates signal. While in case of horn type loudspeaker, we don't vibrate horn along with diaphragm. Horn is just directing sound waves. So if you see the basic definition of horn type loudspeaker, so that is indirect radiating loudspeaker. While in case of cone type loudspeaker, it is direct radiating loudspeaker. And horn type loudspeaker is indirect radiating loudspeaker. So horn does acoustically what cone does mechanically. So cone was vibrating mechanically and it was generating sound. While here horn is just guiding that sound wave, right? So horn does acoustically what cone does mechanically. So horn acts as an acoustic transformer. It provides better impedance matching and it results into efficiency increase by 30 to 50%. And if you see the efficiency which is there with cone type loudspeaker, so that is about 5% only. But here by horn type loudspeaker, efficiency will increase to 30 to 50%. So there will be increase in efficiency by having horn type loudspeaker. So let us see the structure which is there with horn type loudspeaker. Now see, here we have speaker already over here, and in this speaker, this is a diaphragm, and that diaphragm is generating sound. Now see, that generated sound, that is first going in this compression chamber, and here we have a throat of this horn. So through the throat of this horn, this sound wave that is guided in this direction, and it will get released through the mouth. So here there is no vibration of horn. While in case of cone, you'll be finding cone is connected with diaphragm. So cone as well as diaphragm both will vibrate and both combination will generate sound. While in case of horn, is just guiding sound which is happening by the speaker. So we can say horn does acoustic transformation while cone does mechanical transformation. So this is what the basic difference, and structure is very simple. One can see it over here. There will be speaker, that sound will go in compression chamber, and through throat we release that sound via mouth of this horn, right? So in this direction, sound will be there. And you can see here, another horn type loudspeaker is there, where you can see this is what diaphragm. So this diaphragm is vibrating. Here there is a coil to which we are giving electrical signal, and based on signal this diaphragm will vibrate and it will generate sound over here. So this is what compression chamber. Now that generated sound, that is going over here. So this is a throat of horn. Now first it is going in this direction. Now see, this is double horn structure. So it is having transformation of signal in this direction. Again that is redirected by the second horn that you can see, and then it is getting released through the mouth over here. So in this direction there will be generation of sound, and this is what double reflection by horn. So this is having very good directive characteristic. So single horn can have directivity, but to increase its directivity one can go for double reflective surface of horn. So this is even one type of horn where it will be having improved directivity. So its directivity will be very sharp, while this is even directive, but it is having little less directivity compared to this structure. And both are horn type where horn is not generating sound, it is just guiding sound wave. So this is what about structure of horn type loudspeaker. Now see the working. So working, as I have told, air chamber is lined with sound absorbing material. So there will be air chamber, and that we have seen. You can see over here, this is air chamber. Over here it is air chamber where compression of sound is happening. So it will get released through the throat with higher pressure, so that intensive as well as directive sound is released through the mouth. Then cross sectional area will increase with that horn. So you can have that horn which is having cross sectional area that will get increased logarithmically. Horn act as a high pass filter, and if you calculate the cutoff frequency, then that is fc is equals to c into a divided by 2 pi v, where c is velocity of sound. So the sound velocity, that is what c, and at normal room temperature that sound velocity will be around 340 meter per second. Room temperature means at 25 degrees Celsius around, its velocity will be around 340 meter per second. This A is cross sectional area of throat. So this is what throat, its cross sectional area is A, and V is volume of chamber. So see, this is air chamber, its volume is V. So based on this dimension of compression chamber and throat, we can calculate cutoff frequency, that is C, that is velocity of sound, into A, that is a cross sectional area of throat, divided by 2 pi V, where V is volume of this compression chamber. So this is what cutoff frequency of horn type loudspeaker. And in terms of diameter of mouth, lowest frequency produced by horn will be 170 by D, where D is diameter of mouth. So lowest frequency by horn, that is been decided by diameter of mouth. So this is what mouth, if I say its diameter is D, then frequency, lowest frequency produced by horn, that will be 170 by D. So low frequency response is improved by mouth, and high frequency response is improved by small throat. So low frequency response that we can improve by this mouth, and high frequency response that we can improve by this throat. So resultant frequency response is far better by horn compared to conch type of loudspeaker. So this is how horn type loudspeaker is working. Now if you see the directivity, then this is what pattern A, where if I place horn type loudspeaker over here, then its directivity is like this, radiation of sound that is having this type of shape, where for 4000 hertz that will be the characteristic. Now you see with respect to frequency how it is changing. For pattern B it is having frequency 800, so that pattern will be somewhat like this. And for pattern C you will be finding at 400 hertz it is having this type of directivity. So almost one can say in this direction directivity is more, but that even will change with respect to frequency. So that one can observe over here by this basic diagram. For 4000 Hz, it's like this. For 800 Hz, it is directive in this direction, but it is not as directive as it is there with pattern A. But as you reduce frequency, that directivity in this direction will decrease. That one can see. Now it will get dispersed in other direction even. So lower the frequency, dispersion of directivity will happen. Now see the characteristics. So the first characteristic, that is efficiency. So as I have told, efficiency will improve, and that will be about 30 to 40% compared to the 5% which is there with cone type. SNR is about 40 dB, so that is far better than cone type. So for cone type, it will be about 30 dB only. Frequency response is far better compared to cone type. Here you can see it is about 30 Hz to 10 kHz. So horn type loudspeaker is having better frequency response. And distortion is less than 5%. So distortion is even very low. It was about 10% in case of cone type loudspeaker. And power handling capacity, that is even better compared to cone type. It is about 100 watt. Impedance is there with 16 ohm, and this is what the basic characteristic which is there with horn type loudspeaker. Now see the advantages which is there with horn type loudspeaker. So it handles more power, better frequency response is there with horn type loudspeaker, increase in efficiency with horn type loudspeaker. So these are the advantages which is there with horn type loudspeaker. Now see the disadvantages of horn type loudspeaker. See, its size is large. It is heavy in weight due to horn. It is costlier. So these are the disadvantages. Now see the applications. So we can use it for public address system for large audience. We can use this for big auditorium. So these are the applications which. Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in the university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topic which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions which is highly required here to optimize this channel. Thank you so much.